It doesn't want. Oh, my arm is so sore. Open. Things are going wrong. Things are going. Please open. Hola chicos and welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time, then welcome. So as you have read from the title, today we're going to be making our own Oreo ice cream. I'm going to be trying because I've never done it. And thing is, fun fact about me, I love Oreo McFlurry and I have been craving it since the year began. But I live in the ghetto, child, so McDonald's is not here. And every time I'm at a place where McDonald's is there, I'm just too busy to go get an Oreo McFlurry. So now I'm just like, you know what? I'm just gonna do it myself. Because like the universe was like, babe, look at this. And then it showed me TikToks and IG reels of like people making their own Oreo ice cream. And I was like, I can do that. So I went to Pick and Pay in my township and I looked for the ingredients. And they're very different because, like I said, it's ghetto vibes. So I'ma show you. Let's get into it. Let's go get started. Also, how pretty do I look today? You love to see it. Okay, so I'm not sure if I mentioned that this. Oh, there's so much noise outside. Okay. First of all, please ignore not the music, child, the noise in the background. Like I mentioned in other videos, I live in a crèche and people are loud. And sometimes the teachers are louder than the children, so I can't control that. Listen to that. Okay, anyway, we move on. I'm not sure if I mentioned that the recipe is only three ingredients, but it's only three ingredients. And like I said, the Pick and Pay here at my in my township is very ghetto, so they don't stock what you find in your regular Pick and Pay. So look at the Oreos that I got, because they do not have proper Oreos in that long pack. They don't stock it ever. So I got these instead. So the recipe calls for 16 Oreos, but I got 20 because I want extra, okay? And then it also calls for condensed milk. Okay, so the third ingredient shocked me because, like I said, ghetto. I live in the ghetto, so they don't like stock non-dairy products, even though I am lactose intolerant. So I am anticipating to fight for my life when I eat this ice cream. But they had this Olay whip, which is non-dairy. It's dairy free, babe. So it's cream, but it's dairy free. Okay, I'm gonna put it back in the fridge because apparently it's supposed to be cold when you do the things. Okay, now for the first step, we're gonna crush the Oreos. Fun fact, I do not like the cream inside Oreos. Any cream. This is chocolate. I don't like it. I don't. So I'm gonna scrape off the cream first and then put it in this bag so I can crush them. Okay, let's do that. For the time stops for no one. Mother Nature raised the new sun. Okay, so this is I did my best to remove most of the cream. So now I'm just gonna put them in this plastic and crush them. Don't forget to mention divine intervention took place. Photos of the skies that we took on our drives to the waves. Just to see the sea. Okay, so now that we've crushed the Oreos, I'm going to try and whip the cream. So I've never whipped cream before and I don't have an electric mixer, so I'm gonna be doing it like manually. But I looked up some video tutorials on how to do that efficiently, so I'm gonna try and do that method. You will see how I do it in case you need that. But yeah, I'm really I don't know how it's gonna work out because it's also like non-dairy. Like, what if it flops? Oh my god. Okay, so apparently, according to that tutorial, you need ice to make the thing cold. Sorry, it was like frozen to the plate. So let's do this. Ooh, sorry for knocking, y'all. There we go. You can see the coldness forming. And ooh, it's so thick. I didn't expect this. Okay, so I bought two so I can have 500 milliliters. Yo, can you focus on this, please? Focus. Okay, so apparently you just need to whisk. Bro, I'm working my ass off right now. Like, look at that. It doesn't want. Oh, my arm is so sore. And it's still so wet. I'm gonna sweat my makeup off. Oh, my arm. Yo. Oh my goodness, I really don't know what to do, you guys. I think I'm gonna take my chances. This is my whipped cream. Now I'm gonna add my condensed milk. Let me try and open it first. I'm sorry, you guys, like I've been working hard for the past 10 minutes. This thing wants to, oh god, can I open it? Things are going wrong. Things are going, please open. Oh no. Oh, there you go. Oh my. Oh my gosh, I just poured condensed milk all over my thigh. Things are not right. Something is terribly wrong in the state of Denmark. I didn't even measure, I just put the whole thing in there. I don't care anymore, guys. I don't care anymore, I've officially given up. I have officially given up. Oh gosh. Okay. That doesn't look too bad. I'll still eat that. I will still eat that. Honestly, it looks like melted ice cream. So I'm still feeling a bit hopeful. Okay, I'm gonna now put in the Oreos, most of them, and I'm gonna fold them in. I'm gonna leave some for the top. Ooh. Okay, so now I'm transferring this to its forever bowl. This is where my ice cream is gonna reside. Oh no, a piece is stuck. I honestly have no like hopes for this, but as long as it freezes and there's Oreo in it, bitch, I don't give a fuck. Also, I'm so sorry for swearing at y'all. Okay, then I'm gonna put, hold on, come into my hand so I can do this properly. Oh my gosh. Okay, into my hand, por favor, into my hand. Okay, so there you go. Okay, so here she is. I'm gonna put her in the freezer and we're gonna check on her tomorrow. I have no high hopes. My cream didn't want to whip. The condensed milk, I didn't even measure it. You know what? As long as it freezes, I'll be content. Okay, let's put this away. Okay, so I have incurred an injury trying to throw away the tin for the condensed milk. It cut me. The bitch cut me. Oh my gosh. Anyway, I'm gonna put a band-aid on this, and I will check in with you guys tomorrow when we pull her out of the freezer and taste her. Oh my goodness. Hey guys. So it is the next day. It's quite late. It's like 3 p.m. and I just came back from getting my COVID-19 booster shot. So I'm feeling a bit down, but yeah, it's time to check on the ice cream. It's time to check up on the ice cream. I don't know. I don't know what to expect because I fucked it up. I messed it up. The cream didn't whip. The cream didn't whip, and I also got injured. So, you know, let me just get it out of the fridge and let's check. Okay, so here she is, all frozen. She's a brick. She's a brick. Look at that. It's not coming out at all. Nothing's coming out. That is so crazy. Okay, I'm gonna use the Try Guys Without a Recipe scoring system. So I'm gonna score it on taste, creativity, presentation, and is it ice cream? Yes, I think that's the system. So for presentation, I mean, it looks nice, but it's also like, I just poured it in there. You guys saw me, I just poured it in there. With creativity, it works only without a recipe, but I literally just followed the recipe. But I think it's a creative recipe in the sense that most people, when they want to make Oreo ice cream, they just get vanilla ice cream and then crush some Oreos in it. So I think, you know, getting cream and condensed milk is quite creative. And then here comes the taste part of it. It is, oh my god, it is solid. Brick, bro. Huh. But it does look like ice cream. Look at that. Focus. You know you want to focus on her. Anyway, let me taste it. Oh, that is so good. That is so good. Oh my god. And there's Oreo in every bite. There's Oreo in every bite. Okay. Is it ice cream? Yes. Yes, it is. It is. I don't care that it didn't rip. So it, okay. The fact that the cream didn't rip makes it lack that airy feeling of ice cream. But baby, this is good. Yeah, this is ice cream. Okay, let me stop eating it. It's actually really cold outside and I don't want to get sick, so. But yeah, definitely try this if you love Oreo McFlurry like me and you can't get it anytime you want. Make this. Okay, so I wanted to come on here. It's been like 2 days since I've had, not since I've had, but since I've been having and enjoying the ice cream. I have some additional thoughts. So it's very sweet. It's overwhelmingly sweet. Like I can't have more than 3 spoons. So I would advise that if you don't have a sweet tooth like myself, lay off the condensed milk. Like don't pour all of it. Just pour just a little bit or half the can, not the whole thing, please. It is very sweet. Oh my goodness. And in terms of the lactose, it's not that bad. I think the fact that I used dairy-free cream helped it because the lactose in the condensed milk is not doing much to me. So I'm not fighting for my life as much as I thought I would. Okay, back to the outro. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you liked it, please give it a big thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel, comment. It helps out the channel, actually. a lot, and I really love what reading the comments. I will see you guys next week, hopefully, because I don't have an idea for next week. So maybe you guys can tell me what you want to see in the comments, because I'm actually running out of ideas. So yeah, tell me what you want to see, and I will see you guys next week, hopefully, if I have something to do. And yeah, I will see you soon. Ciao.